In this video, we are going to calculate the definite integral from 0 to 1 of the fraction x plus 1 over x plus 2 divided by the fraction x plus 3 over x plus 4. This question is from the 2023 MIT Integration B. Then how to solve this integral? We're going to simplify the inside part first because here we have fraction divided by a fraction. So we can use I for this integral. Then here, I just here from 0 to 1. Then on top, x plus 1 times x plus 4 divided by x plus 2 times x plus 3 dx. Next, we want to simplify the bottom by defining a new variable, so that we'll have something easier to integrate. So we're going to define a new variable t, that t equals the average of these two factors. So this is a typical method for something like this. So now let's see, so we're going to let the t equals the first factor, x plus 2, plus the second factor, x plus 3, then divided by 2. Then simplify, we have x plus 5 over 2. So x plus 5 over 2 is the middle point of these two fractions. So now let's see what is the lower bound, upper bound for t. Here, the lower bound and upper bound for x are 0 and 1. So now let's see here. So the lower bound for x is 0, upper bound is 1. Then we have the lower bound for t, put a 0 here, which is 5 over 2. Put 1 here, the upper bound for t is 7 over 2. So next, from t equals x plus 5 over 2, solve for x. Then we have x equals t minus 5 over 2. So next, we're going to do the substitution. So let the t minus 5 over 2 replace all the x here. So now let's continue with this equal sign. So here, the integral, the lower bound, upper bound. So here, 5 over 2, here, 7 over 2. Then on top, after simplified, which is t minus 3 over 2 times t plus 3 over 2. Then the bottom, after simplified, so here, just t minus 1 half. Then here, t plus 1 half. Then here, dt. Then next, look at here. So this one is a t minus 1 half times t plus 1 half. It's like a minus b times a plus b. Then equals a squared minus b squared. Then here, the lower bound, upper bound. Then the bottom, so here's a squared, which is t squared, minus b squared, 1 half squared, that's 1 over 4. Then look at the top, the same thing. So t minus 3 over 2 times t plus 3 over 2. So a minus b times a plus b. Then equals a squared, which is t squared, minus b squared, then 9 over 4. Then here, dt. Next, so here we are going to do something on the numerator, because here we have t squared minus 1 over 4. So then here we can do this. Then here just 5 over 2, here 7 over 2. Then the bottom, so here t squared minus 1 over 4. Then on top, we're going to do this. So t squared minus 1 over 4, then plus 1 over 4. It's like plus 0. Then write down this term. Then here, minus 9 over 4, then dt. Next, we're going to separate from here. So the lower bound, upper bound, then separate from here. So then the first term is 1. Then the second term. So combine these two together. That's negative 8 over 4. That's negative 2. Then here, just negative 2, the bottom, t squared, minus 1 over 4. Then here, dt. So next, we're going to separate this integral into two parts, separate from here. Then the first one, the integral, just the upper bound minus the lower bound. That's for the first integral. So now let's see the second one. Take the constant 2 outside. So here, just 2, the integral, 5 over 2, 7 over 2, then here, 1 over t squared minus 1 over 4. Then here, dt. Simplify this part. That's 1. So now let's see this integral. We want to simplify the inside part first. We want to reduce the power because here the power is 2. We want to reduce the power from 2 to 1. Then we can separate this integral into difference of 2. We can separate this fraction into difference of 2 fractions. Then here just equals 1 over t minus 1 half. Then here just 1 minus t plus 1 half. Then here dt. It's pretty easy to check it. Okay, so when we do the common denominator, then put them together, we got this one. Okay, they are equivalent. So now the power from 2 to 1. Then they are pretty easy to integrate. Okay, so then here 1 minus the integral of the first one, just log t minus 1 half, then minus the second one, t plus 1 half. Then the upper bound, then the lower bound. Okay, so next, let's simplify the inside part by doing the common denominator. So then the bottom, that's 2, top 2t minus 1. Do the same thing here. Do the common denominator. So 2 on the bottom. So here 2t plus 1. Then here, just upper bound, then the lower bound. So let's continue to simplify the inside part first. So here, the difference of two logs, based on the rule of log. So difference of two logs equals log ratio. So then here, just log this part divided by this part. Then simplified, 2 and 2 canceled. So here, just 2t minus 1. Then here, 2t plus 1. Then here, upper bound, lower bound. So here, just plug in the upper bound here and here. So then, so this one, just 7 over 2 put here, that's 7 minus 1. So on top, 6, plug in this one here, which is 8. The minus, plug in the lower limit here and here. Then on top, 2 times 5 over 2, 5 minus 1, that's 4. Then on the bottom, put this one here, which is 6. Then again, so here, difference of two logs equals log ratio. Then here, just log. So this one simplify, which is 3 over 4. So then top, 3 over 4, then divided by, so this one simplified, that's 2 over 3, so divided by 2 over 3. Then here, simplify this one, and just 9 over 8. Then we can take these two here as a power. Then here just 9 over 8, put these two here as a power. Then just 1 minus log, then 9 squared, 81, 8 squared, 64. So 1 minus log of 81 over 64 is the answer for this integral. Thanks for watching.